Alright guys, well you've seen me building this kind of house, and this is same dimensions roughly as this house. We've got 5 blocks across the top here, as you can see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This episode I'm going to be building something slightly larger. I've already like planned out over here, and this is using 7, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So this is obviously significantly larger, and I'm going to build it kind of, I might as well just build it opposite to this one. Yeah, might as well. I'll do something that makes them different later on so that my village isn't filled with the same buildings. But yeah, let's go. So this is kind of a concept video on how, if you want to build your own Nordic houses, the rules that you should follow. So we're going to start off by building the two end walls, as they are very important. Obviously, we're going to be going across 7. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. You can do this anything length you like, except I highly recommend doing an odd number. Otherwise, your roof's going to look fucked up. Next thing I'm going to do is that's going to go up 2 blocks, and then I'm going to put a row on top of that. You could obviously go higher, and that would mean that this looked a little bit taller up to there, but your roof would be nice and bigger, and that would be quite nice. But I'm going to stick at 2 for now, and I've put a row of steps on top. Now I'm going to put a row of steps on the bottom and one at each end, like that. Now I need to work out my length. So this is quite important. When you add in your second wall, it's not like this. It is out one. These buildings are a little close together. When I've got single player commands, so I can move them. And now these walls are 3 blocks high. We don't have the little step on these because you won't actually see the top. So I'm going to go along, and I'm going to try and work out how far along. So I'm normally I like gaps of 3 on buildings of this size, but because I'm going for a slightly larger one, I'm going to have a gaps of 4. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4 blocks. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, and then there's a block where the beam would be, and then 1, 2, 3, 4. Now hopefully this is the right length. You can check, because it should be an odd amount. You should be able to put a block in the middle, and you can see that that is in the middle. Then we're going to do the other wall, so we're going to go up 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2. There we go. And then I'm going to go along with our little steps like this, and that creates a nice curve effect to the building. Well, not curve, it creates a nice I don't know. Yeah, it just makes it look like it's attached to the ground, which our buildings were very attached to the ground. Then we're gonna go all the way along here, doing this edging like so. Now, next stage we're gonna do, so we're gonna knock out the blocks on the corner, in the middle, and in the other corner. And this is where our eaves are going to go. So we're going to have a 3-eaved house. Oh yeah, and you can actually put in your block here. Obviously I'm using my texture, which is a complete block of wood. But you can do it just using normal wood if you're not using my texture pack, or if you just prefer that. You know, or of course if you're doing this legitly. This house will be pretty much texture pack dependent, but you won't need it. I'll give an alternative. So there you go, there's the edges, and you can choose. I prefer seeing this gap here, I don't know why, I just prefer it. But you can fill that in if it will make your OCD happier. That's just a personal preference. So, we'll go, oh, I've done it wrong. Oh well, never mind actually. So what I've done is I've done it 3 blocks, like a 3 block gap. So when I counted 1, 2, 3, 4, I actually counted 1, 2, 3 with a end. But never mind, that's actually fine. So it will be slightly different to this one, although I definitely will need to move them further apart. So our doorway is going to go here. I'd quite like to make something a bit more of it, so I'm going to give it a cobblestone edging like that. So you walk up into the house, and this is something I've played around with but not really done properly. So I'm going to raise the floor by 1, and normally I wouldn't do this because the roof's already pretty low, but because the roof is kind of high anyway, and we've actually raised the roof further by making it have such a high gable, we can get away with this, no problem. There we go. Next thing we're going to do is add in our gables. So you just come up all the way up to the centre, and then up from the other side, like that, and then delete the blocks underneath. So, we're going to go up in the middle, up in the middle, delete the blocks underneath, doop doop doop, and go up, boop, 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 and boop, delete all the blocks in the middle. Oh, failure, you failure. Can't wait till I get single player commands back. Updated, damn it. Now, yes, posh voice. What we can do is we can fill in this block here, and that means that this beam goes all the way down to the floor, which looks a lot nicer than if it doesn't, although I think that that looks really weird and I hate it. So to compensate for that, on the inside I'm going to add in these blocks here, which kind of gives the impression like they're touching the floor. Alternatively, you could use these blocks here, but I just prefer the look of the wood. I think wood is sexy. So next thing we're going to do is involving the top part of the roof all the way along the top. So actually no, before I do that I'm going to do the thatch, and before I do that I'm going to go to sleep. There we go. Oh yeah, you can't sleep when you're standing on top of a bed, can you? That's retarded. There we go. Okay, so I'm going to start off with our normal thatch ball. Now what you can use wood for this, you can use wooden steps for this, but I'm going to leave you to work out those problems on your own, because it's a whole different set of shit, but I just prefer what it looks like in thatch. I am being called. Allow me to just decline that and then type in recording, give me a moment. Okay, and then we've got, oops, no, go away. There you go. So that's all the those bits for now. Then I'm going to go along with my edging block. Obviously if you're using wood, then this will just be exactly the same as the rest of it. Why is my frame rate dropped? There we go. And go up there. Note that I haven't put the blocks on the top row. That is important. Come along here. Now, when we get to this bit, which is going to be our doorway, we have a choice of either putting up a nice big tall bit like that, and then a bit of cobblestone, or lowering this bit of wood down. But I'm going to leave it up, because I like the look of it when it is up. That is what she said. And I'm going to go across there, and then give it all the thatch. We like thatch, don't we? Yes, we do. We like a bit of thatch. It's very pretty. And then you're going to fill in the gaps with your normal thatch. This is also another nice thing about doing it in segments, is this, what is normally a really, really tedious, boring task, is actually not too bad, and you can do it quite fast. Oops. There we go. I have Nevada in my head. How the fuck did that happen? Never mind. Oh yeah, and obviously we want to give this the edging as well, so that it looks extra prettyful, you know. Choke. Alright, now we need to do the top. So what we're going to do is put wood at each end. And now there are a few ways to do this when you're doing your own house. You'll notice on this one, I have a half block here. So you just basically want to find a nice curve where it's very shallow in the middle and it comes up and then suddenly goes rough at the end. Maybe not that extreme, but you know what I mean. So I'm going to go for, wait, you see three here? This looks a little bit too tight. That's what she said. Fucking useless. Right. And add in our end pieces so we can get a good look at how it looks. And it looks alright. Hold on, let me just experiment. I'm going to put in a half block at each end as well. Yeah, I think that looks good. That's a nice curve. Seems fine to me. Another alternative you can do is by putting, using the half blocks at this, on this bit of thatch here. But I won't be doing that. Actually, yeah, I'll do it just to show you how you can do it. So that'll be along like that, then a block, and then failure, like that. Or you could give it the bullhorn effect by going like that, but that looks kind of silly on this kind of roof, so I'm not going to do that. I'm going to do that one. Okay, so there's the outside of a building almost done. We're just going to go inside to add the finishing touches to the inside. And what we're going to do here is a kind of checkerboard design. Now you don't have to do a checkerboard design, there's lots of different ways that you could do this, but I kind of just like the checkerboard one. There you go. And then you can add in these here, that looks quite nice. And to break it up a little bit more, you can add in steps here rather than full blocks. I think that adds a lot of fidelity. It looks quite pretty. You can even fill up this all together, but I'm not going to do that. You could even do that. Lots of different things you could do. You could even do that. But yeah, that's up to you. It's quite nice to see the inside of this wall here. I think that's why it's quite effective. Another thing you can do actually is fill in these gaps all together. That way you get a nice even spread. That is actually quite nice. I think I'll stick with that one. So let's fill in these. Give it a bit of that. And then go doop, 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 doop. And then doop, doop, doop. Failure. Oh, wait. I meant to use these, aren't I? Suddenly just got very dark in it. Ah, that looks really cool with the light coming through. Very cool, very cool. I wonder if it works here. Ha! That is quite cool. I like that. Okay. What else? Oh yeah, of course I can just add in these. There we go. So there's our interior. Isn't it pretty? I'm not going to bother furnishing this. You guys all know what it is. But what I'd like to show you now is how you would do a roof light. Not a roof light, a roof chimney. So say in the middle of the room here we have our fireplace. I will mark it out with cobblestone. We have our fireplace here. Now actually, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now I think that will catch fire. I think the roof is just one block too low for this to get work, but never mind. Let's grab here, up to the top. Now, the way I do this is by taking fences, fence gates, wherever the hell they are. There they are. I've got some wooden stairs and some wooden slabs. No, I don't think I need the slabs, I just need the stairs. No, I do need the slabs. Yeah. And another thing I like to do is to, first of all, give it a bit of this. It just frames it a lot nicer. Now, if you used wood or wooden half steps for the rest of this roof, then it will look, you know, obviously you shouldn't really use wood again at the top, so you can use wood, but I'd rather use cobblestone like I have in this one over here. You can see it looks slightly weirder, but never mind. Okay, so let's add our top piece in. You can put steps on here. If that triggers your OCD, sorry, but you know, you can kind of see that it doesn't really work properly, but never mind. It's kind of unnoticeable. Put down the steps, put down the things on top of the steps, then add in the three. On one of my houses I did a 4-block-long one, which I will show you very briefly before the end of this video. You add in two of those like that. That does a nice job at breaking that up so it doesn't look like one solid block at the end. Oh, actually, then you put one half block in the middle and then one facing each way on each side, which creates this lovely little top piece like that. It's quite a nice little fun thing to do that. And then on the inside, it looks like the chimney smoke will go straight up into the chimney. You could also add in like a little ladder or something so you could walk up here and look around, see if anyone's attacking you. Whew, okay, I've been talking really fast this episode. That is pretty much all I want to show you. I hope you like this build. I hope you have no problem following this tutorial. And I'll see you guys next time.